Good morning, students. Welcome to your geography class. I hope all of you are well. Today we will discuss the same chapter, drainage, with you all. Okay? We discussed the first part of this chapter. Today we will start from the Himalayan rivers. As you know, the Indian rivers are categorized into two parts: is Himalayan rivers, the most important, and of course then we have the peninsular rivers as well. They are as well as important in the peninsular region of India. Okay, so what are the Himalayan river systems that we have in our country? We have Indus, Ganga and Brahmaputra. These are the three major Himalayan rivers of our country, and each and every river system or drainage system is having their own importance. Okay, so first we will discuss about the Indus river system with you all. Now as you can see, the river Indus rises in Tibet near the lake Mansarovar. So this is the origin of Indus river. If you see the textbook as well, their map. Now this is the place in Tibet, this is Mansarovar lake, from where Indus river originated. Okay, so from Mansarovar lake in Tibet, Indus river is originated. Now it is an west after originating from Mansarovar lake. If you see, Indus river flow towards west and it enters India through Ladakh. If you see, this is Indian border. Here Indus river is entering India through where? Through Ladakh district. Now the river Indus rises in Tibet near Mansarovar lake. So this is the origin. Now it moved towards west and it enters India through Ladakh. Okay, it forms a picturesque gorge in this part. Okay, in your previous class we discussed what is gorge. Now gorge means when a river constantly flowing through an upland area or from a mountain, it separates that area into two parts. Okay, due to continuous flow of the river, it, because it's doing its erosional activity, so it separates the mountain or upland area two parts, and it creates a deep narrow channel over there. This is known as gorge or scar, deep scars over there. So we call it gorge. Now this type of gorge is created by Indus river at this point, because Indus river is a Himalayan river, constantly is flowing, is carrying a huge amount of water, and because it is river's upper course, so it's doing its erosional activity, so it's created automatically and gorge over here. Okay, now several tributaries. Now not only we have the Indus main river, we also have its tributaries. What is tributaries? The tributary means when some streams or channels are going to merge with the main river. When a stream or a channel is going to merge with another main river, we call it tributaries. So the tributaries of Indus river from India or from Kashmir region is Zaskar, Nubra, Shayok and Hunza. Okay, these are the tributaries of Indus river from Kashmir region. Not only these are the river systems only, we also have so many tributaries of Indus, but specifically these are the tributaries of Indus river from Kashmir region, specifically from Kashmir region. It is Zaskar, Nubra, Shayok and Hunza. Okay, now as you have seen the map, Indus originated from Mansarovar in Tibet, it enters India, it also moved towards Pakistan as well. Before partition, it was the whole Indus river system was a part of India only. Before partition, okay, but after the partition in 1947, now a part of Indus river system is belongs to Pakistan. So not only Indus river system, a part of Indus river system we have in our country, we also have Indus river system in Pakistan as well. So Indus flow through Baltistan and Gilgit and merges from mountains at Attock. So where basically Indus river merged with Pakistan. Now after crossing, after entering Ladakh, then it crossed Baltistan and Gilgit, then at Mount Attock it merge with Pakistan. Okay, or it enters Pakistan. We can say it merge with Pakistan or it enters Pakistan. Now the Satluj, Peace, Ravi, Chenab and Jhelum joined together to enter Indus near Mithankot in Pakistan. This is also very important. We have seen Zaskar, Nubra, Shayok, Khunza. These are of course the tributaries of Indus River only, but from Kashmir region. Now in Pakistan, we also have Satluj, Bees, Ravi, Chenab, Jhelum as the tributaries of Indus River system. And where all these tributaries merge with Indus River? Now near Mithankot in Pakistan. See, this is the area. If you open your map book, you will get to see this is the place where all the tributaries, Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Satluj, okay, Bees as well. These are the rivers or tributaries basically merge with Indus River at Mithankot in Pakistan. So these are tributaries of Indus River from Pakistan. Okay. Now beyond this tributaries and all, Indus flows southwards eventually reaching the Arabian Sea. Okay, now as we know, the western portion of Pakistan is basically dry region, okay, or arid region. So Indus River not flow more westwards to the Pakistan. What is doing now? It's more flowing towards south of Pakistan, and at Karachi it merged with Arabian Sea. Okay, so as Indus started from Tibet, it moved towards west, it enters India, crossed Ladakh and Kashmir, more west it moves, it crossed or it enters Pakistan as well. But here in Pakistan is not moving more westwards direction, it moved towards southwards direction, and at Karachi it merged with the Arabian Sea. Okay. So Indus flows southwards eventually reaching the Arabian Sea at east of Karachi. Okay, you can write specifically east of Karachi or just Karachi. Okay, it's good to write specifically east of Karachi in your exam. Now Indus plain has a gentle slope. Now as we discussed in our previous class, okay, river system. Okay, river system means where we include the area, its tributaries and distributaries as well. So the whole Indus plain region is very gentle slope. Okay, as it's a plain area, it's having a very gentle slope. So what is the total length of this Indus river system? It is 2900 kilometer, which is huge. So the longest Himalayan river system. Listen to this very carefully, because sometimes during your exam students are having the confusion, like if the question is about what is the longest river system of Himalaya, then your answer will be Indus river system, because its length, as you can see, 2900 kilometer. But if the question is about what is the longest river system of India, then your answer should not be Indus river, then your answer should be Ganga river system. Okay, so if the question is about only Himalayan mountain rivers, then your answer, the longest river of course, then your answer is Indus. But if they ask you the question in an exam, longest river system of India, then your answer should be Ganga river system. Okay, so don't get confused during your exam. Before writing the answer, check what they asked you. Okay, now so total length is 2900 kilometer. The Indus is one of the longest river of the world. Now here once again students are having confusion. Indus river system is not the longest river system of the world, it is one of the longest. Okay, during an exam, if long question is coming, don't write Indus river system is the longest river system of the world, because it is not. Nile is the longest river system. Largest one is Amazon. Largest Amazon, longest Nile. Okay, and Indus river is the one of the longest river system of the world. Okay, so these small details when you are learning, very careful. Now, a little over a third of the Indus Basin is located in India. So, one third of the total Indus River system is now at present belongs to India. Of course, after the partition, it includes the states of Jammu, Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Punjab. Okay, if you see the Indus River system, because river system means not only the main river, it also includes tributaries as well as distributaries. Okay, so Indus River system includes the states of India is Jammu Kashmir, Punjab, and some of Himachal Pradesh, and majority of this Indus River system is belongs to Pakistan at present. Now, after this, so this is the all about Indus River. We learned the features of Indus River, from where it's originated, what are the tributaries of Indus River from India, what are the tributaries of Indus River from in Pakistan, what is the total length, where it merged. All these are the very important features of Indus River system, and all these things you have to learn. Now, you have this next, do you know? This is also important for exam. Okay, now in this, do you know, if you see, according to the regulation of Indus Water Treaty, now because before partition, in the total Indus River system is used by India, means in East India as well as West India, right? But now after the partition, now western part of India known as Pakistan, right? So there was a clash. There was a clash that who will get what percentage of the water. As Indus River started from Tibet but enters through India and moved towards Pakistan, so there was a clash who will use what percentage of the water. So in 1960s, between India and Pakistan, we have a treaty, we have a proper agreement that 20% of the water carried by Indus River will be used by Indians, or it will be used in India. Rest 80% of the water will be used by Pakistanis or in Pakistan. So we can't stop the flow of the Indus River. Maybe Indus River enters through India only, but it's not that whenever we want, we are going to stop the flow of the Indus River. Okay, no, we can't do that because we have an agreement in between these two countries, or we have a treaty in between these two countries, because Indus River system is the largest river system in Pakistan. So most of their agriculture system is depend upon this river system. So we can't stop the flow of this Indus River, as we not only we have Indus, now we also have Ganga and other rivers as well in the whole country. So 20% of this river system we are using in India, and rest 80% is used in Pakistan. Okay, this is a treaty between India and Pakistan in 1960s. So I hope up to here is clear everything. Now next, the most important river system of our country is Ganga River system. Okay, now the headwaters of Ganga, called the Bhagirathi, is led by Gangotri Glacier and joined by Alaknanda. So from our childhood only, we thought that from the beginning only it is known as Ganga, but it is not that. From the Gangotri Glacier, where the main stream of Ganga River originated, it is known Bhagirathi over there. And as well as another stream, Alaknanda, is also there. Okay, from another glacier, we also, from the Himalayan range only, we also have one more stream known as Alaknanda. At Deprag, you can see the real picture in your textbook as well, figure 3.5, where Bhagirathi Alaknanda meet at Deprag. Okay, so at Deprag, this both the streams, Bhagirathi, which is originated from Gangotri Glacier, and Alaknanda, another system, merged together, and combination of these both streams now known as Ganga, and flow towards the eastern direction of India. Okay, if you see the map as well, you will see this is the two streams, right? Two streams, two line, you can clearly see in your map. This two stream, one is Bhagirathi, one is Alaknanda, both they are flowing according to the direction, according to foothills or slopes of the mountain at Deoprayag, because Deoprayag is the foothill area of Himalayan mountain range. So at Deoprayag, both this river stream merged together. Now it is known Ganga here, and it's moved towards more east of India. So Deoprayag is located in Uttaranchal. Now at Haridwar, the Ganga emerged from mountain on the plain. So at Deoprayag, both the two streams, Alaknanda and Bhagirathi, merged together with, and they, after that, they known as Ganga. Ganga, now this is the foothill, as I said, this is the foothill area of the Himalayan mountain. Now after crossing this foothill area at Haridwar, Ganga River enters the plain region. In your previous chapter, you learned that we have the three range of Himalaya, then we have the northern plain range start. Okay, so at Haridwar, basically Ganga River merged with the plains of India. Okay, so, and as you know, Deoprayag, Haridwar, these are also known as holy cities of India, right? For so many reasons, these cities are very much important in our country. So next feature of Ganga is, the Ganga is joined by many tributaries. As you have seen in Indus River, same goes for Ganga as well. Ganga is also merged with many tributaries from Himalaya. A few of them being major rivers such as Yamuna, Gharghara, Gandak and Koshi. So there are so many rivers merged with Ganga River, but the basic main tributaries of Ganga rivers are Yamuna, Gharghara, Gandak and Koshi. Yamuna specifically rises from Yamunetri Glacier in Himalaya. If you see the map, you will see Yamuna River is also originated from a glacier which is known as Yamunetri Glacier, and it is also flowing parallel to Ganga. It is also flowing parallel to Ganga. But at Allahabad, both these two rivers, Ganga and Yamuna, merge together. At Allahabad, Ganga merge or join, or you can reversely can say Yamuna basically join with Ganga River. So this is known as, so that's why Yamuna is known as tributary of Ganga, because at Allahabad, Yamuna joined with Ganga River system. So Yamuna is known as the tributary of Ganga. Now, not only Yamuna is there, there is also Gharghara, Gandak, Koshi, which is originated or rise from Nepal Himalaya. If you see the map, this is Nepal, you can see this is Nepal written, and all these three tributaries, Gharghara, Gandak, Koshi, is coming from Nepal Himalaya only. So these are the rivers which flood parts of northern plain. As you know, because these are perennial rivers, they are having water throughout the year. But what happened during monsoon season, these rivers are also getting some more water, as monsoon is providing water to every single part of country. So these rivers are also going to get monsoon water. So what happened, now already they are having water in their river, okay, because they are getting the water from the melted snow or melted glacier. Now they are going to have extra water during this monsoon season. So automatically overflow of the river will happen, and this overflow of the river is known as flood. Okay, so every single year in this rivers, okay, we have flood. Now of course flood is devastating, it's not good, because it's going to hamper human life, it's going to destroy the property, human life as well. Okay, but there is a positivity. Now every single year, because we have flood in these rivers, so the areas which is close to these rivers, they are getting every single year renewed soil. It means khadar soil. If you remember your previous chapter, we discussed about bhangar soil and khadar soil. So due to flood, every single year the close areas of this river systems are going to get new alluvial soil, which is known as khadar. And as you know, khadar soil is very much important for the agriculture purpose. Okay, I hope up to here is clear to all of you. Now the main tributaries which come from, now these are the Himalayan tributaries of Ganga. Now next we'll discuss about the peninsular tributaries of Ganga, which is coming from the peninsular upland area. Now these are Chambal, Betwa, Son. So three A peninsular tributary of Ganga is Chambal, Betwa, Son, and these are coming from semi region. These are basically coming from peninsular region. Okay, these of course now because they are coming from peninsular region, peninsular areas, we don't have any glacier, so their course is very much short. Their length is very much short. Okay, so these we have two types of tributaries of Ganga. One is Himalayan tributaries, another is peninsular tributaries. Okay, next thing, as you can see now, this water merged with Ganga from both the side, from left side, from right side. We call it right bank tributaries and left bank tributaries. Okay, if you see the map, see we have Gharghara, Gandak, Koshi from one side, from other side we have Yamuna, Chambal, Betwa and Son. So from both the right and left side we have the tributaries of Ganga. Now Ganga flows up till Farakka in West Bengal. Okay, we know Farakka is situated in West Bengal. So up till Farakka, Ganga flow. Now you will say, ma'am, it's not true. It's not up till Farakka. Farther also we have Ganga. Yes, but up till Farakka, the flow of the river is known as Ganga. What happened? After Farakka, Ganga river is no more known as Ganga river. Here, at this region, at this plain area of Farakka, Ganga river bifurcates. It means separates into two parts or splits into two parts. Up till Farakka, the main river of Ganga flow. At Farakka, Ganga river bifurcates or separates or splits into two parts. Okay, this is known as distributaries. When a main river separates or splits or bifurcates into two or more than two parts, known as distributaries. Okay, so at Farakka, the river system separates in two parts. One part is known as Bhagirathi Hugli, which flow southern part and it merge with Bay of Bengal through West Bengal. Okay, through West Bengal, it flow more towards the southern direction of West Bengal and merge with Bay of Bengal. Another part of this Ganga river enters Bangladesh, same like Indus river. Before partition, Bangladesh was our part, so that part of in Ganga river also belongs to India only. But after partition, now that part of Ganga river, which is known as Meghna in Bangladesh, covering after the Bangladesh merged with Bay of Bengal. So these two are the distributaries of Ganga river. One is Bhagirathi Hugli, which we have in our country in the southern part of West Bengal. One we have Meghna. So one part of this Ganga river enters Bangladesh, and in Bangladesh it is known as Meghna. And at Bangladesh, Brahmaputra and Ganga river merge together and form a huge river system, flow towards Bay of Bengal and created the largest delta of the world, which is Sundarban Delta. Okay, Sundarban Delta is created by Ganga and Brahmaputra river together as they merged both at Bangladesh, and after that they moved towards the Bay of Bengal, and due to the depression activity they created this type of delta. Okay, now the Sundarban Delta derived its name from Sundari. This do you know is important. Now from where Sundarban got its name? Now there is one more question. Now how Sundarban got its name? Now because in Sundarban Delta region we have Sundari trees, and from Sundari trees basically this area got its name Sundarban. Now the length of Ganga is 2500 kilometers. Okay, so compared to Indus, Ganga river system length is less, which is only 2500 kilometers, but it is the longest river system of India. Now next thing, you have seen Ambala located on water divide between Indus and Ganga river system. Okay, so if you see this particular part of the map, you will get to see that this portion of Himalayan mountain range, okay, we have Ganga and this side we have Indus river. In between Ganga and Indus we have Ambala as a water divider. I hope you remember what is water divider. In between two river system or channel, when we have an upland area or a mountain, So in between Indus and Ganga, we have Ambala, which works as a water divide between Indus and Ganga. Okay, so this is also important, that what is the water divide between Indus and Ganga? It is Ambala. Now, so from Ambala to Sundarban, okay, the stretch of this plain region is basically 1800 kilometer plain area. We are talking about a plain area. So plain area from Ambala to Sundarban is approximately, not, it is approximately 1800 kilometer, and the fall or the height of this plain region is within 300 meters. The northern plain region, which is created by Ganga river system, so this is basically within 300 meters the height. But as we know, plain does not mean you have a smooth surface. Okay, in plain as well as we have some slope. At a distance we have some slope. So same thing happen here in Ganga river system. At some point, after every 6 kilometer, we are going to have at least 1 meter of slope, and these slopes helps Ganga river system to create meander. As I said already, meanders are created by rivers only when in plain areas rivers are going to have slope. So wherever it's going to have the slope, it will flow through that only. So when it's flowing through the slopes, it's create that U shape. Okay, this is, which is known as meander. So in plain region as well, because we are getting at some point up, we are getting some slopes, so we call, so for Ganga river is possibility to create meanders. Okay, so today we'll discuss both the important Himalayan mountain rivers, which is Indus and Ganga. Okay, hopefully this video helps you to understand both the river system well. Thank you students, thank you for watching today's video, and rest of this chapter we'll discuss in your next class. Thank you everyone.